Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2110. 15 digits of precision? Maybe not always. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jalen. Now, this is for the people who have this fundamental belief about Excel that numbers in Excel only have 15 digits of precision. And you get burned by this. You know this because if you try and paste some credit card numbers, see these credit card numbers from Notepad here, the fake credit card numbers, of course, don't go try and steal the credit card numbers here, ending in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. When I paste those to Excel, first I get scientific notation, but I change it back. And Excel can't deal with the 16 digits. It can only deal with 15 digits. This is well known. It's a thing, all right? Here's another thing that's well known, is if you have 10 people here and you have their scores and you use the rank function, equal rank of B4 within that range, and two people are tied, Excel is going to rank both of those people, Edie and Helen, as a rank of 3. And here, Della and Ivana with a rank of 6. And no one is going to be ranked 4. Right? This is well known, well documented. And the reason that this irritates me is because I like to use this trick where I sort with a formula using index and match. And whoever was supposed to be ranked 4 is instead ranked 3. So Helen doesn't show up in this list. And whoever's supposed to be ranked 7 is ranked 6, so even it doesn't show up in the list. But that's okay. We have a great workaround for this. The workaround is we take the rank and then we add to it how many things above us, how many things above us are equal to this item. All right, so let's come down here to Ivana. All right, so Ivana, the rank is going to return 6, but then we say, well, look at everything above us from B3 to B11. B3 to B11, that's this right here, and see how many times 40 appears in that list. Oh, well, it appears once in that list, so we're going to arbitrarily give even a rank of 7. Is it fair that she gets a 7 instead of a 6? No, but it allows my sort with a formula to work correctly. All right, well-known workaround. It happens a lot. But then, last week on YouTube, I get a question saying, hey, can you go check this question at the Mr. Excel message board? And I went out and looked, and Muhammad's using a variation of this, rank and countif, and he says, it's not working. All right, and the people at the Mr. Excel message board said, oh, no, you're just not doing it right. But he posted the spreadsheet. He said, well, here, download it, look. And he was doing it right. There were values here, and for some reason, two people using this formula that works, is supposed to work, two people are being ranked 7, and no one's being ranked 4. I have to tell you, it was a mystery. And, you know, I tried all the things. I tried all the things. Here's the first thing I tried. I said, well, let's see if what's stored behind the scenes is really equal. Is this 115% equal to that 115%? Excel said yes. Is this 115% equal to that 115%? Sure. How about this one? Is this one equal to that one? Yeah. How about this one? Is this one equal to that one? So according to Excel, these things all are storing 115%. And you think, oh, it's the floating point decimal problem, but let's do Ctrl in the Grav accent so we can see what's really being stored in there. And sure enough, these were calculations, and some of them are being stored out to a lot of digits, but the 115 or the 1.15, it's flat out 1.15. But then I said, well, let's try this. Let's see what's going on. You know, it's a mystery. I can't figure it out. So I came over here and I sorted descending based on the score, right? And when you sort descending and you have a tie, Claire, Flo, Ivana, and Lucy should all come together, all right? Now watch this, watch. I'm going to do data, zeta A. Claire, Flo, Ivana, they stay in the same order, but for some reason, Lucy jumped from last to first. That shouldn't happen. If this was a dead tie, there's no reason that Lucy should move. In the case of a tie, it stays in the original order. This should be Claire, Flo, Ivana, Lucy, not Lucy, Claire, Flo, Ivana. There's something going on here. All right. So I asked a few people. And someone said, well, hey, let's crack this thing open. Change it from a .xlsx to a .zip. Dig into the XML. And they pointed out in the XML, those four values are not 1.15. It's 1.499 and a whole bunch of nines. 1.499, 1.5501. right? And we pulled this number out, and I put it here in a Courier New Font, so it would line up. And then here I just counted how many digits there are, and this is me just typing 1 space 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 1 2 That's 17 digits. I mean, I checked it. I looked. Did I screw something up? Did I miss some digits? No. Excel is storing 17 digits. Hey, what's up with this? Excel only stores 15 digits. Everyone knows Excel only stores 15 digits. But for some reason, in the XML, in this file, they're storing 17 digits. And the first thing I think of is, yes! That means that they're working on the credit card problem. That means they're working on handling 16 digits. This will be a great improvement. But here's the problem. So right now, even though they're storing 17 digits, a lot of Excel functions, COUNTIF, COUNTIFS, the equality test, is this equal to that, are using 15 digits. But some things, like sorting and rank, are breaking the rules and using all 17 digits. Right? And so that means that this well-known workaround for rank plus COUNTIF, if you happen to have something that's different in the 16th or 17th digit, is going to return the wrong answer. That's bad. We don't like Excel to return the wrong answer. All right? I don't know when they started storing 17 digits. It's just kind of dumb luck that we ran across this file and realized that they're storing 17 digits. So that means that we have this let's say it's a fairly bad workaround. So what you're going to have to do is whatever calculation you were doing to get these numbers, whatever calculation that was, you're going to have to start to wrap that calculation in an equal round. You're going to have to take that number and round it to the nearest 15, 14, something, right? So that way, even in the case where they're secretly storing 17 digits, you're going to force it to be, in this case, 14 after the decimal, 1 before the decimal, 15 digits. And now that fixes our problem. Everyone has every number, every rank appears exactly once. Yeah, this is a weird one. This is, you know, fundamental belief. 15 digits of precision. It's been that way for a long, long time. It's like they're halfway to fixing it, maybe going to 17. Some of the functions are using 17 and some are using 15, and you say, well, why does that matter? It's out there in the 16th and 17th position. But in this case, it clearly matters. And it you know, it shakes your faith in recalc or die, right? Something is wrong here. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.